Across the country, we are seeing states begin to open up, and this time once and for all. We've seen Freedom Day in New South Wales, and now the Victorian lockdown that started off as 7 days is finally coming to an end this week. The basis, of course, for the return to our liberty and freedom has been driven by the vaccination rates. And while we started low, Australia is now in the enviable position where 84% of our population, aged 16 or above, has had at least one dose. This is great, but there is one glaring area of concern. The vaccination rate for Indigenous Australians is woefully behind the general population, with an almost consistent lag across the country, irrespective of state or territory. According to the Commonwealth Department of Health, the vaccination rate for Indigenous people in Australia is 26% lower than the non-Indigenous population, with just 57.5% of Indigenous people across our country receiving their first dose and just 42.3% of Aboriginal Australians receiving their second dose. The delay is universal, and whilst we've had to deal with remoteness in places like Northern Queensland, Western Australia and the Northern Territory, our capital cities are still profoundly behind. There's a 46% differential in the vaccination rate of Aboriginal people and non-Aboriginal people in Perth. In Darwin, there's a 24% gap. Now, we know that due to overcrowded housing, the lack of access to healthcare, and the chronic disease burden, which disproportionately impacts our Indigenous population, that a COVID infection can burn through our Aboriginal communities like a bushfire. At a Senate hearing last week, the chief executive of the National Aboriginal Community Controlled Health Organisation admitted that Indigenous infection rates are more than double the non-Indigenous infection rate. This is now an issue of national urgency and requires immediate national leadership. We need the Commonwealth Government to step in and get the job done because, unfortunately, almost every single state and territory thus far has failed to provide adequate vaccination coverage. We've all seen the result of what happens when there is national leadership. The Prime Minister and the Commonwealth took us from way, way behind on our double dose vaccination rate to well ahead. Well, now is the time to act, because if we do not, we will risk wiping out generations of our First Nations people. There's no other way to put it. COVID will wipe out our elders and it will erase important Indigenous cultural history that we simply won't get back. Australia has to do better, and we must take action now, and that falls upon the Commonwealth Government to intervene and override the states and territories to make sure we get the job done.